Hey, you bloody bitch, where the fuck you at? Hey, what is up, you guys? It's your girl, Gina Chong, back with another YouTube video for you today. You probably clicked on this video for the title down below. Yes, guys, today we're going to be playing Bloody Mary, so grab your glass, grab your wine, because it's creepy video time. A lot of you guys have probably played this game before, or have wanted to play this game before. I played this game before quite a few times growing up as a child, and I know there are plenty of different ways all over the internet and the ways that you can play it. So I'm going to actually go over the rules on the internet on how to play it, and then I'll talk to you guys about how I used to play it, and then we're going to actually play the game. I just Google searched the rules because it's Google, and if Google don't have the answer, who will? Alright, but the rules that show up on Google basically say, place your candle in the bathroom, and we have our candle. Right. Right. Here. So, you place your candle in the bathroom and light it. Stand and look into the mirror, chant slowly. Bloody Mary. Bloody Mary. Bloody Mary. And see what happens. It's up to you to believe what you may or may not experience. If nothing happens, try spinning around 3 times and look into the mirror. See anything yet? I know I heard a couple different ways online. Like, there was one way online that they said that you needed to spin around in a circle like 13 times and repeat it in the mirror however many times. The way that I remember playing it as a child, there was like a little backstory. And if you want to, well, we're going to get into the backstory. So basically, the way that I remember this, there was about 2 or 3 different stories, but the one that I remember the most was there was this lady named Mary, and she had a baby, and the lady Mary ended up going psycho, and she killed her baby. And I don't remember exactly what about the bathroom, but I know that there was definitely something about the bathroom. And I think it was like, no, because that's Blue Baby, where you flush the baby down the toilet. It was something about the bathroom, or maybe she threw the baby into the sewer, but I remember it was something, like, obviously it had to relate to the fucking bathroom. So all you needed to do, and when we were children, we didn't hear about the candle. It was like me and my cousins and my brothers and sisters, we would play it all the time. Like, we would spend weekends over my aunt's house. Street, stop tearing up my furniture! I remember spending weekends over my aunt's house, and we would go and just like giggle and laugh in our bathroom, run in and out playing the game, and nothing happened then. So I honestly doubt that anything's going to happen now. And it's not, thing is, about these games is personally, I'm a little bit of a skeptic, and not even about the games. Like, I'm not saying that I don't believe in the paranormal. I'm just a skeptic on a lot of things in general. I feel like a lot of things that people say could be paranormal can be debunked. Any paranormal experience that I've thought has been even remotely paranormal in my life, I've had people debunk it for me. If you've watched my other YouTube video about my paranormal experience, or I saw a ghost, it was something titled like that. I'll link it down below. But every time that either I've thought I had a paranormal experience or something in that manner, I've always had somebody debunk it for me, or I've always assessed the situation and debunked it myself. And that's the thing about a lot of the paranormal, like, videos on YouTube and things like that, is people won't go and actually investigate, and they won't debunk it themselves. Am I saying that the paranormal doesn't exist? No, I am a complete believer in the paranormal. I believe that it is there, that it can happen. But do I believe all these YouTube videos with chairs flying across the room and all these cabinets being torn open right on video? No, because I don't believe that ghosts are actually going to show themselves like that. And honestly, I feel like when you play these games, it's more or less in the sense of what you want to bring. If you play these games with a negative vibe or a negative energy and or intent to bring negativity, then you're going to attract something negative. But if you play these games with positive vibes and positive energy, and you're only playing these games for the fun of it and not to bring anything into your life, then I don't feel like anything will happen. And honestly, that's what I'm going to prove today. And this video was, if you want to look her up, I will link her down below. Even though you watched my video, you better know who she is, because how the fuck do you know who I am and do you not know who she is? Yes, I'm talking about Britty44, hashtag team Britty44, hashtag Berithorens. Hey, yes, girl, hey, if you're watching it, you probably not, but yes, this video was inspired by Britty44. I love watching her videos. She's all about the paranormal. She's all about, like, actually debunking stuff, and, like, she's straight up fucking real with it. Like, she doesn't joke around. If something happens, she's gonna let you know what happens. If something doesn't happen, she's gonna be straight up and say, nothing happened. Honestly, that's what I'm doing here to do today. I'm gonna let you know if something happens or if something doesn't happen. I'm gonna be straight up real with you. It's like, we're gonna play the game, and if nothing happens, I'm still uploading this video, so it doesn't even matter. Alright, so guys, next time you see me, I will be in the bathroom all set up to play Bloody Mary. Hey, you guys, we're back, and yes, I am all set up in the bathroom so we could play Bloody Mary. Alright, so one thing I didn't mention earlier is I'm actually home alone. Derek's at work, and Liam is spending the night over at his aunt's house. And if you hear any noises, it's probably not Bloody Mary, it's streets, because she feels the need to be in the bathroom with me because there's nobody else here. As I said earlier, we have our little candle here, and it is red in honor of Miss Mary. And, well, let's begin. The rules of the game were simple. You say Bloody Mary in the mirror three times with the candle shone over you. Bloody Mary, Bloody Mary, Bloody Mary. Miss Mary. Oh, Miss Bloody Mary. What were the other rules? We needed to spin around three times. Do I say it when I spin around? I'm going to say it when I spin around. Bloody Mary. Bloody Mary. Bloody Mary. Oh, Miss Mary. Miss Mary. Hey, you bloody bitch, where the fuck you at? I mean, I got some tampons. I'll hook a sister up. Show yourself for my viewers, please. Well, as you guys could see, nothing happened. Sorry. If you actually like this game, or if you like the idea of this, or you want to see me do more, comment down below. There's been a couple different ideas that I've seen, and we do, there's this one called, like, Blue Baby, Baby Blue, or something like that. There's this one that I've been dreading doing. I think it's, like, called Druma Songs. It's like a bathtub game, but I really want to play it. I'm just fucking terrified of doing it. Any games that you could think about, I'll have no fucking problem playing, because this shit honestly is nothing. I'm pretty sure that's streets, don't worry. Alright guys, but if you enjoyed that, please comment down below your Bloody Mary experiences. Give me a like to let me know that you liked this video, and if you like this video, also subscribe. I appreciate it. Share this video, it helps. Alright, smash the shit out of that subscribe button, and that was Gina Chong, and I am out till next time. Bye.